So let's look at another example. The neat thing about function notation is you can say f of x, let's call f of x squared minus x minus 8, but you can also call something like g of x, and g of x is just another function entirely, so negative 3x minus 8, that could be g of x. So these are both functions. These are both functions, except they have different names. Two different functions with different names. And I can specify, I can say, well, I want f of 2. I'm going to treat this the exact same way as I have before. If I have f of 2, I'm going to plug 2 in to this first equation up here. So everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 2. 2 squared minus 2 minus 8. 4 minus 10, negative 6. But if I ask for g of 2, I'm going to do the same thing, except I'm going to plug it into the second equation, to the g equation. So I have negative 3 times, instead of x, I'll write a 2, minus 8. So negative 6 minus 8, negative 14. I'm going to ask for g of 0. Again, I'm going to use the second equation. Negative 3, everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 0. And everything else stays the same. And we're golden. It's kind of cool. Alright. So something else that we can do that's kind of neat, that looks a little weird when you do these problems, is we can ask you to do something like this. So what is f of g of negative 3? Now the key to working these problems is to work these problems from the inside out. So work these problems from the inside out. So really what I want to do is I want to focus on what's going on the inside. I can solve g of 3, make that prettier. I'm going to work on solving this, then I'm going to go from there. So I'm going to take a problem I don't know how to solve, I'm going to solve the part that I can do, and then I'm going to worry about the rest of it later. So again, I'm going to focus on finding g of negative 3 and see what I can do with that, because I don't know what else to do. So I'll start at g of negative 3. So I've got minus 3. Where I see an x, I'm going to put a negative 3. Minus 8. So I've got 9 minus 8 is 1, I think. Yes, got it. I can do this. So g of negative 3 is 1. So I'm going to take this 1, and I'm going to substitute it into that, right? Because g of negative 3 is 1, so that means I can plug in 1 for g of negative 3, right? So I could say that f of g of negative 3 is the same thing as f of 1. If I go back and I look at my equation up here, so that I have it. Alright, so I've got my little function here, so I don't forget what it is. Alright, so I have f of 1. So everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 1. So I have 1 squared minus 1 minus 8. 1 minus 1 minus 8 is, negative 8. So f of g of negative 3 is equal to negative 8. So that's pretty cool. It's actually a really, really neat thing to be able to do. let's work an extra problem. And again, I'm going to copy these and bring them down because I think it's hard to do this if you can't see them. Okay, so let's do this again. So let's say that now I'm going to ask you for G of F of 2. All right, so again, we're going to work these from the inside out. So I'm going to focus on what's going on here. I want to find F of 2. So I'm going to go and do this. So everywhere I see an X, I'm going to put a 2. 2 minus 2 minus 8. I think I already did this one. Negative 6. So since F of 2 is negative 6, that means I can replace F of 2 with negative 6 anytime that I want. So G of F of 2 is the same thing as G of negative 6. So I could say that everywhere now, I'm going to use the G function, everywhere I see an X, I'm going to put a negative 6. And that's going to give me 18 minus 8. It's going to give me 10. So I can say the G of F of 2 is 10. Now there's a special name for these kinds of functions. And that would be your answer. Your final answer. So there's a special name for these functions. And the special name for these functions is called composite functions. They can also be called nested functions because they're like nested inside each other. I like to think of them as snuggly functions, but don't tell anyone. Because they like to snuggle. They like giving each other hugs. They're very affectionate functions. Anyway, but whenever you see these kind of functions, what you want to do is you always want to start on the inside and you want to work out. Just take it a step at a time. Don't be intimidated. They're trying to scare you, so just don't let it work. Work from the inside out. Simplify the inside. Do the substitution. You're never going to see more than two of these nested together. So, have fun.